How's it going, everyone? It is Andre Williams, and over here we talk stocks and we focus on one thing. Always protect your profit. Also got to put out the disclaimer. I'm not a financial advisor, and this isn't financial advice. So just know when you do invest, you're doing it at your own risk. So today we're going to be talking about AMC. So before we get started, let's go over the agenda. The first thing that I'm going to be going over is the technical analysis, taking a look at the overall price action and what we saw today inside the market and what things can look like potentially going into tomorrow. We also want to see, hey, where are those prices that we want to see AMC finish at as far as for the end of the day, which you guys will probably be seeing by the time you actually watch this video. And then secondly, we're going to be taking a look at the order flow distribution. What do I call this? The diamond hands versus the weak hands. Are people buying up shares or are they selling most of the time? Well, we're going to figure that out. And then when all of that is done, I'll be giving you guys my final thoughts. So let's get into it. So we're going to do a technical analysis for AMC. So let's see how it performed on the day. So ended up closing at $59.04, being up 3.58% on the day. On the low, it tested $56.73, and then on the high, testing $64.71. So one of the things that we want to take a look at, yes, we ended up getting to a high today at $64.71, but of course, we knew this $60 area was a level of resistance. So knowing that we were able to get past this area of resistance here, and we got to $64.71, we have to look forward to actually beating this sometime this week. If we're able to beat this sometime this week, then I'm definitely looking forward to seeing a strong move where we test the resistance right here around $68. So what I want to see from AMC is being able to finish today just above 57 bucks. So this is taken into consideration at the end of after hours. If we can finish above 57, then things are definitely looking really good. We already noticed a lot of volatility in this play, so that's something to be expected, all right? So now if we take a look, if it does decide to show a pullback. So if it decides to pull back at, I'm letting you guys know right now, this $56 level does look like an area that AMC is able to hold. We're able to hold that throughout the regular trading hours. We know there's going to be a lot of manipulation going on in the pre-market and as well as after hours. But like I stated previously, as long as we're finishing above, whether it's 57 or even 58, either or, things are going to continue to look good for AMC, which is definitely great for a lot of my apes and a lot of my holders out there. So just taking this into consideration, what I want to look forward to seeing tomorrow is being able to surpass the highs that we saw today, which I think is very doable. So hey, we just got to be patient and see what the price action gives us. Now let's take a look at the order flow distribution for AMC. So we can see on the inflow side, we had 3,705, and on the outflow side, we had 3,708. On the large side, we had 58. On the medium side, we had 3,082. And on the small side, we had 565. On the outflow side, we had 48 that was large. On the medium, we had 3,102. And then on the small, we had 557. When we take a look at the large scale orders in the last 5 days, look at all those green candles right there. So that just means as far as large scale orders are concerned, there is a lot of buying going on. You can see for June the 15th, which is today, it was at 9,946.86. So taking this into consideration, yes, people are continuing to buy and hold, and we're also seeing this on the institutional level as well. So as long as this stays consistent in regards to the stock price that you're currently seeing, even if it's not where you think it should be, don't even watch that. Don't even worry about that. There's a lot of manipulation going on in this play, and that's why I want you guys to be aware. But there's certain stats that we take a look at on this channel to help you and let you know, hey, whether we're going in the right direction or not. And from looking at the order flow, things are looking pretty good. So now let's get into the final thoughts. So for my final thoughts for AMC, things are continuing to look strong. Part of the reasons being is we were green on the day. So what does that mean? Yes, these short sellers are sweating buckets, and they're going to continue to lose money as long as we buy and hold. All of my apes out there know how it goes down. Anyone who's considering to get into a position with AMC, please be aware of this and make sure that you can invest with money that you are not afraid to lose. You can't have all this emotion in the money that you have. You can't even have an immediate need for that money because, again, this play takes some patience. You also have to realize that there's also a lot of volatility in AMC as well. So do yourself a favor and really distance yourself from all of the FUD that you see out there in the media. It is made to put you out there to discourage you and get you to panic sell. So ignoring it is one of the things that you could do to make sure that you're going in the right direction and you have a good understanding of this play and where it can potentially go. Now, another thing to take a look at, the matter of the fact is the inflow and the outflow. When we look at the order flow distribution, hey, we're seeing a lot of strength on the inflow side, and those large scale orders are continuing to pile up, and it's been happening for the past 5 trading days. As far as for the price of the stock, you might be saying, well, it should be higher, but at the end of the day, if we end up being green or we end up just finishing stronger overall in general, it's something that you cannot ignore. Also, do know there's going to be a lot of manipulation that goes on in after hours and as well as inside the pre-market. It's easier for these short sellers and these scammers, that's what I'm going to be calling them, since they just want to use counterfeit shares and so forth to manipulate the price of the stock. But when regular trading hours goes in and it starts to continue, then this is where you pay attention to the price action and you take it a little bit more seriously here. So what I'm going to be doing, yes, I'm going to continue to buy and hold when I see pullbacks. For now, I'm just going to be holding my position because I do have a good amount of shares already. Another thing I also want you guys to understand, the short interest information is going to be coming out later in the evening, and I'll probably pop it up somewhere, maybe as a message quickly across the screen so you guys can see it. But of course, we can't rely solely on this information due to the fact there's a lot of naked shorting going on and we're not even accounting for that. It's unable to actually do that, right? So that's what I wanted to kind of update you guys on. All of my apes continue to buy and hold. And of course, if you want to get into this play, only do it if you can afford to do so. Hope you enjoyed this video, and I'm looking forward to seeing how AMC does tomorrow.